Hi my friend, I'm just back from climbing and look at what I just got here. Well actually, you have no idea what's in there. Let's take a look. So you can see it says fragile, manipulé avec soin, which means we're gonna be careful with it. And we've got a nice, tiny, little guitar. Check this out. But first, let's eat, because I'm fucking starving right now. Tasty Portuguese chicken with fries. That's the best thing. Piri piri chicken sandwich from Smiles. Oh my god. Fucking awesome. So you know how there's normal full-size guitars? That's a full-size guitar. A big, fat, heavy, full-size, full-body guitar. Then you have three-quarter-size guitars and half-size guitars. And then you have this tiny, little, cute guitar. They call it travel size and that's exactly the reason why I bought it. So it sounds pretty good to me. I'm not really used to playing acoustic guitar. It's actually my first acoustic guitar. So yeah, I have yet to give it a name. Give me suggestions in the comments. But I really like it so far. It's like super tiny, but it still sounds pretty loud and pretty warm, which I really like. So let's talk a bit more about this guitar. As I said, I bought it because it's really small and travel size, which means I can easily bring it like to the cottage or like camping or something like this and have a guitar handy without like carrying a massive guitar that's super heavy and an amplifier, because so far I only have electric guitars, so it's really inconvenient for this kind of stuff. And I'm also left-handed, which means like wherever I go, I never find a guitar, you know, left-handed that I can play, which is really frustrating. So this is gonna make it easier to have this guitar with me, to bring it places, without it being too much of a hassle. And it's also electroacoustic, which means I can actually plug it into an amp if I want to, so that's really nice. I'm gonna try that a bit later. What I really wanted was like a small, inexpensive guitar as well. Like if I bring it to the cottage and we go outside and it starts raining, or we're like making a campfire and there's like some, you know, fire stuff that goes all around in the air. Or if I want to take it on the lake on a canoe in the middle of the night, I'm not gonna be too worried if there's some water on it. So yeah, I wanted a cheap guitar, and this one was $250, which I find pretty reasonable. It says it's made in China. Well, handcrafted in China, and I'm really happy with the sound so far. It's my first acoustic guitar, so I don't really know that much what to expect, but to me it sounds great, it sounds pretty loud, and I just played it with my bare hands, not even with a pick, so it's pretty even louder with a pick. Actually, we can just try that right now. I think while it's lacking on the bass side, obviously, but it's so tiny, like you can't expect too much on that. So yeah, all the low notes are not like super bassy, But otherwise, I'm really happy with it for the convenience you get. I think it's really worth it. I brought a jack because I'm pretty curious to see what it sounds like on an amplifier, so let's try that right now. It's actually funny how they put the jack input over there where you attach the strap normally. I'm gonna have to turn the zoom down a little bit because it's pretty loud. Like the sound. Let's try a bit with the distortion. So it sounds pretty good with distortion too, but I think it's weird with the distortion coming from the amp, but you still hear the, well, acoustic part of the guitar as well. So I prefer the clean sound a bit more because it mixes better together. So that's it for today, my friends. Let me know in the comments what you think of the Beaver Creek Travel guitar. So far, that's a thumbs up for me. I really like it. I like the sound and I think it's gonna be very convenient to bring to the cottage and to bring to camping and stuff like this. I also like that it's electroacoustic, that I can plug it in to make it louder, and that it's pretty cheap, so I don't have to be super worried about it when I take it on random adventures outside. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers! Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, it's a round back. So well, it's got literally a round back, which makes it pretty comfortable and nice to handle, so I really like that as well. Ah bien sûr, j'ai plus de mémoire, bah tant pis hein. Ah bah voilà, qu'est-ce que tu veux que je te dise mon gars? On va juste s'amuser.